There's quite a lot of variables involved in setting up a trial here. Understanding the relationship or the interaction between a foreign animal disease agent and a Canadian species of aquatic animal gives us the heads up. In many cases, these scenarios have not occurred yet, and we would like to know what might happen if an exposure occurred, and we want to have tests that can detect these agents ahead of time. This DFO lab actually consists of leased space within the Canadian Food Inspection Agency building.
We're a level 3 biocontainment facility for aquatic pathogens that we can basically guarantee that aren't going to get out into the environment.
We're working with live viruses or bacteria that the animals are exposed to, so we have to be aware of that when you're moving from one tank to another for feeding or for maintenance or anything like that. So it just offers an extra challenge that you have to be aware of, and it kind of slows your day down a little in that regard.
The process of establishing an animal disease model in the lab involves somehow to expose the animal to the infectious agent. For instance, with our work involving infectious salmon anemia, we decided to inoculate the fish through injection in order to ensure a consistent dose of virus was introduced into the experimental fish. You have to do it carefully. We pull fish out individually from the holding tank and anesthetize them to reduce the stress. And then we use a fair number of transfer points because we want to eliminate any accidental introduction of virus to the holding tank.
So when we're moving or we're handling animals, the key is to handle them as few times as possible. So you want to map out your netting procedure, how long they're going to be in a bucket, oxygenation, the temperature is controlled, and you just basically want to treat the animal as kindly as you can.
And over the course of the next 8 to 12 weeks, we're going to measure shedding rates, the amount of virus given off by these populations of infected salmon into the water.
So once the animals are infected, we will collect them at certain intervals, and then we'll do a necropsy. We harvest tissues, and then we will analyze those. So first we have to extract the RNA or the DNA from the tissue. And then we will take that and we will amplify it and make it large enough that we can detect it using a machine.
Many of our studies result in little or no interaction. Not everything we do results in disease and death of the host. We're fairly specific in the rationale behind the work we do, and it's directed at supporting the economy, supporting trade, and protecting our aquatic animal resource.